Kentucky is at or near the top of a deadly list, child abuse.
Tonight, WLKY's Karen Roby begins a series breaking the abuse with a story that proves the abuse can and does affect all families. You'd be hard-pressed to find a better family than Dr. Michael Nethers and his wife Susan, a registered nurse. When their daughter became a teen mother, their grandchild was given every chance at happiness and a full life. But that was destroyed when a six-month-old girl died in one violent moment. Tonight, Aleyah's story.
In this nursery, time stands still.
I'll never understand it.
Yeah. A baby's laughter.
I've never in my life seen a happier baby.
No longer echoes here. Aleyah Noel was born August 8th, 2012. She was a preemie.
We had gotten in a car accident and it caused her to stop growing. They induced me.
Her mom, Mackenzie, was still in high school when she gave birth.
It was extremely tough. I mean, she was 17.
Aleyah's father, Barry Williams, was 20. It was not a relationship Mackenzie's parents ever approved of.
We didn't like anything about the relationship.
I never trusted him.
But Mackenzie was devoted to Aleyah.
Yeah, she's a fighter. Strong.
And at first, Williams appeared to be a devoted father.
For a while, it was perfect.
But soon, that perfect picture began to fade.
We now know how totally controlling and isolating he was making Mackenzie.
Williams began to demand his newborn daughter stay with him overnight.
I would beg to keep the baby, and she would always say, I need to ask him, and the answer would be no.
And I could only think about how many other teen parents, like teen dads, didn't want anything to do with their kids, and he was literally arguing with me over spending time with her.
Mackenzie increasingly gave in, making sure she was there at night when Aleyah fell asleep, and in the morning when she woke up. But on February 26th last year, her daughter would never open her eyes again.
She was, you know, making noises and moving, but I just couldn't get her to wake up. I asked him, you know, what happened? Did something happen? And he said, she's just sleeping, nothing's wrong. So I called my parents.
Mackenzie's parents would know what to do. Her stepfather is a prominent doctor, her mother, a respected nurse.
She won't open her eyes, and she's just moaning. And I can hear her through the phone. I knew something terrible had happened.
Aleyah was rushed to Hardin Memorial Hospital. Mackenzie's father, who is an OBGYN, was in a nearby operating room. As Aleyah struggled, Dr. Nethers arrived to find an awful picture emerging in the CAT scan.
As soon as the images started flashing up on the screen, I knew.
Baby Aleyah was transported to Cozair Children's, breathing only with the help of machines.
Basically, at that point, she was dead.
And the cause was as clear as that CAT scan picture.
This is the most classic case of shaken baby pathology that probably exists.
He shook her to death.
He, Barry Williams, the father. Police immediately began to question him as his daughter lay dying.
At the hospital before she died, he was arrested.
Williams admitted to violently shaking his daughter to stop her crying. He was sentenced on January 21st to 20 years in prison for murder.
You've seen the pictures. She laughed. What she else? Smiled. She never cried.
But under her smile, Aleyah's happiness hid an awful truth.
At the hospital, we found out that she had other injuries. She had old healing fractures.
Aleyah had been abused many times before.
The signs weren't there, and I looked all the time. I looked all the time. And that's part of what was so gut-wrenching and hard for me.
Aleyah took her last breath on February 27, 2013.
There's always going to be that part of you that feels like there was something you could have or should have done. I'm sorry.
Aleyah Noel was just 6 months old when her family was forced to say goodbye.
It's not fair. It shouldn't have to happen. It didn't have to happen. That's what makes it so hard.
Even with all of their medical knowledge, the Nethers never caught the abuse that was happening to Aleyah before that she suffered that deadly shake. But a pediatric forensics expert says there are subtle signs that can help you spot violence before it becomes deadly. Tomorrow at 5:30, that doctor shows us the cutting edge that is already breaking the abuse. I'm Karen Roby.